Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I give God the praise and the glory on this morning. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. As always, welcome to the Deliverance and Restoration Channel. I thank God for those of you who took the time out of your day to drop by my channel and support what God is doing on this platform. I genuinely thank God for all of you. For your genuine support and your fellowship. And I hope all of you and your families are doing well as we all grow in the Lord together. For those of you who are seeking spiritual growth in the Lord, I genuinely thank God for you. As always, it is a blessing and a honor to be used by God as an instrument to bring healing and deliverance into the lives of others for the glory of God. Ministry is my calling, and I embrace it. I have a passion to see those, to see people delivered and set free, and establish a relationship with God through His Son Jesus. That is my calling, and it's a blessing to see the work of the Lord done into the lives of others through spiritual accountability, encouragement, spiritual growth, conviction. All of these attributes of God lead to spiritual growth, and I thank God. My desire is that this channel become a buffet, of the things of God, to where the real issues of God are ministered on this channel. I want this to be a place that you that people come to, and they can find a video that pertains to every area of life. That is my desire on this channel, that I don't talk at you, but that I allow God to use me to talk to you and deal with these issues that must be addressed, and several issues that many people are afraid to address. However, I thank God for those of you who are standing in the gap, those of you who are watching on the wall, those of you who are on the battlefield of the Lord, allowing God to use you and use this platform to, be used by God to break the chains of the enemy. I thank God for those of you who are in position and standing in the gap, being a witness for the Lord, the Lord's way. I thank God for you. Excuse me. Okay, there is a word from the Lord this morning. I'm led of the Lord to continue with the video I posted yesterday, Get Into Position. This is Get Into Position Part 2. For those of you who have not seen the first one yet, I'll document that as Part 1. This is Part 2 here. There were some other areas that I want to cover. I did receive a phone call at the end of the first video I posted yesterday, so I had to stop and take care of some other business. But I will... I'm going to finish it today. Now, the word of the Lord, as we were discussing yesterday, is that many of you, your breakthrough depends upon you getting into position and to alignment with God. Hallelujah. Now, you already have the faith to believe that God will do it. Now, it is very important that you get into position. Let me give you another example. Noah. God came to Noah and gave Noah specific instructions to build an ark. And for those of you who are very familiar with that passage of scripture, God gave Noah piece by piece how to build this. Now, the ark would have never been a reality if Noah did not do what the Lord said do. Let's look at the reversed end of what could have happened. Let's say if Noah never allowed God to use him to build that ark, what would have happened? You can be in position with, you can be a child of God and miss your blessing because you didn't move and do what God told you to do. But Noah, he moved. So we're going to lock in on Noah. Okay. Noah moved. Not only did God give him a word, but he moved. I don't know who I'm talking to, but I sense this. Hallelujah. There is urgency for someone to move. Someone that's going to come across this. God is telling you to get into position. He's already given you the word and you have not moved. Now, for those of you who are in position, for those of you who are in the will of God and you've had the faith and you've already got into position for breakthrough, I'm not talking to you. I thank God for your obedience. I thank God for your refusal to be stagnant. But for those of you, I ask that you would pray for those who are struggling to get into position and they are struggling to leave their comfort zone. Glory to God. So many times, what God will tell us to do, sometimes it requires your comfort zone to be broken. He's telling you what to do, but what God is telling you to do, it is uncomfortable to you. Glory to God. Many of you, your breakthrough is around the corner. Some of you, you're waiting on the timing of God before he delivers you, before a breakthrough comes, before a door is open. The timing of God is crucial. Hallelujah. If you look at the book of Noah, it took a while before it to rain. It took a while before the earth was flooded from the time God told Noah to build the ark. There was a time lapse in there. The timing of God is everything. Everything's about the timing of God. Now, I'm going to talk to you about the timing of God in pertains to being into position. Okay. Now, let me use my life as an example. Years ago, maybe in the earlier years of my marriage, most of my work was physical labor. I liked to do physical jobs. And that was the first part of the earlier years of my marriage. And then one day, the Lord spoke to my wife, and my wife told me, she said, honey, it's time for you to change your job path into office work. And it was very different for me because I was used to doing physical labor. I had never did office work a day in my life. And I had got to a point to where I felt like it was time to change jobs, but I didn't know what to do. I was always used to physical labor. So I did what God spoke to my wife, because what God spoke to my wife, it bear witness with my spirit. And I began, there was a particular office sales job that was maybe 30 minutes from where we stayed at that time. I stepped outside of my comfort zone and I applied for this job. I got into position. God gave my wife the word. Then he confirmed it with me. And I got out of position. I stepped out from my comfort zone and I went to apply for this job. And they hired me immediately. I dressed up, put on some very business professional attire that was very important to look the part. And they hired me immediately. Now, I had never done a sales job. I had never worked in an office environment, never. But I knew that communication and talking was my gift that the Lord had graced me with, being able to identify and talk to people and to be able to connect and reach people. When I went up in this sales job, after they trained me, I excelled immediately. I continuously hit my sales goal. I learned the job very quick. I was very quick on my feet in terms of trying to sell people, talking to people, communicating with these customers through this headset at this computer office desk. It was maybe 20, 25 reps per team. Now, because I did what God told me to do and I moved, God blessed me on that job. I was there for like 2 years. God blessed me tremendously because I stepped out of my comfort zone. He gave the word and I moved. Who am I talking to? Somebody, you need to move. God is trying to transition you, hallelujah, into a breakthrough, and you need to move. I feel that. Move. Get into position. Get into position. Because I sense in the spirit, you know what God is saying. If it's that business, get into position. Get into position. And begin to work and be led of God so that business becomes a reality. Because somebody right now that's going to come across this, God is giving you an amazing business idea. And there is a market for the idea that you have. There's a market for it. And people need the services that you offer. The worst thing that you could ever do is be gifted and be anointed and don't move to allow that gift to be used for the glory of God. Rather, is it even in ministry? Some people, God has called you into ministry, but you won't move because it affects your comfort zone, or it doesn't make sense. Fear, the enemy, hallelujah, my goodness, the enemy uses fear of the unknown to keep people from moving forward into position. Get into position. There's even somebody that might even come across this. God told you that he was going to send you your God-ordained wife or your God-ordained husband. But some of you have not got into position yet. Or some of you, it's not time yet. It's not time for it to become a reality. Our time is not God's time. The timing of God is always different than what we think it should be. I'll use my own life before I go back to God-ordained marriages. There's several blessings that I wish I would have got earlier in my walk. Listen, some blessings I just not have obtained 20 years after I prayed it. I am now 43. Some of these blessings I prayed when I was like 21 and they just now become a reality. Listen, God has a set time to bring deliverance in your life. The most important thing for you to do is to get into position. Hallelujah. And wait for the will of God to become a reality. Many times what we pray for, it happens immediately. Sometimes it takes place at a shorter distance. And sometimes these breakthrough happens years out. God is in control and he knows what's best for us even before we do. Now, back to marriages. Some of you, God-ordained marriage is approaching your life, but many of you are not into position. Some of you are not in position with God yet to be a husband. You are not in position with God yet to be a wife yet, because there's some things that have to be broken off your life. There's some things and some way of thinking that is not of God that has to be broken off of your life. Now, I say this for some people. Some people there, they have matured and they're just waiting on the timing of God. And there are some people who have not matured enough to be ready for God-ordained marriage. Because some people, if they get into marriage right now, out of being out of position, it's going to cause trouble in the beginning of the marriage. Because there's some people, they have not let go of anger. They'll carry that anger into their marriage. They have not let go of certain sins that God told you to let go of. And you'll carry that into a God-ordained marriage. And it'll be a problem. Glory be to God. That's how the Lord works. You must be into position to obtain the things of God. And there are some people, some things are never going to happen until you get into position. Get into position and do what God is calling for you to do. Get into a position of obedience, a position of holiness. Get into position, a closer relationship with God, and everything else to fall in place according to the timing of God. For the Bible declares, seek ye first, what? The kingdom of God and what? All of his righteousness. That has been the kryptonite of people. They want the things of God, but they are rebelling against the righteousness of God. And the scripture says, and all these things shall be added unto you. Put God first, seek him, avoid sin as much as possible. And everything will fall in place with the timing of God. Get into position. Get into position. Get into position. You know who you are. You feel God calling you to make a move. You feel God telling you to do this. You feel God telling you to go to this position. Some of you need to get into position by disconnecting yourself from fake friends who don't mean you no well. Now, here we go again with this, because I said this, I've been saying this a whole lot lately. Get into position. Disconnect yourself. God, and you feel God calling you to disconnect yourself from evil, fake friends who don't mean you any well, that are holding you back from your breakthrough. Get into position and disconnect yourself. Pray for their deliverance and disconnect yourself and focus on the things of God. Glory be to God. There are some people that need to make a move. There are some people that need to relocate. Get into position. Get into position. That's what I love about Abraham. Abraham got into position. God told him to leave your kindred, leave your comfort zone to a place that I will show you and make you great. Get into position, people. And Abraham, hallelujah, Abraham moved. When God gave Abraham a word, and Abraham moved. God gave Joseph and Mary a word to depart. And Joseph and Mary moved. Get into position with God and do what God is telling you to do. Let me share this with you. Back in 2007 and 8, the Lord began to tell me and my wife to leave South Carolina. He told us to prepare to move to Georgia, close to Atlanta. We had been in South Carolina, born and raised in South Carolina. Around our family members, we had all the support we needed. And God said, I want you to move to Georgia. I have work for you to do there. And it was very difficult at first, but we did what God told us to do, and God blessed. And Georgia is our home. But God gave us a word, and we had to move. There's somebody you need to move and get into position with what God is telling you to do. Move, get up and move and do what you feel in your heart that God has told you to do. You already know it. He already told you what to do. Whatever it is that you hear God tell you to do that does not make sense, move. Abraham moved. Noah got into position. Mary and Joseph got into position in regards to Jesus. Glory be to God. Get into position for breakthrough and for victory. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Whatever your position is, get into position. God will not fail you. Now, let me deal with this. The timing of God is everything. Now, God gives a word. And within the timing of God, he leads and guides us when to make a move. Some of you, God has already told you. He's already given you the green light to go after those things. Do not miss what God has for you in this season by not moving. You have to give the word of God that God spoke over your life movement. Back in December 2018, the Lord told me, after God healed me from the things that I went through in the religious system, because again, I took several years off away from preaching. And I told myself I would never preach again. I told God, all I want is you, God. All I want is you and my family, God. I don't want to deal with these people. I don't want to deal with these religious people ever again. I don't want to preach anymore, you know. And I was really hurt by what I experienced in the religious system. Now, God gave me time to heal. And in December, God said, I want you to begin to minister on YouTube. And people who know me know that I'm a very private person. Me and my family love to be low key, and we love to just have peace and serenity. And I was very private. I said, God, I do not want to expose myself to the social media. Because I was totally against social media for so many years. But I understood that social media can be used for the glory of God. Social media within itself is can be used for the glory of God if you choose how you utilize these tools. And so I stepped out of my comfort zone and said, okay, God, I'm going to get back on the battlefield. And I started a YouTube channel. God is blessed. I've came across so many genuine people who love God. I pray for so many people. I fellowship with so many awesome people. And I thank God for it. But I stepped out of position. And what this channel is right now is not the end reality. God said, continue to press, continue to plow this ground, continue to plant these seeds, and I'll get the glory out of your channel. But I had to move. I had to get into position. Some of you, there's some people that are waiting. Their blessing and breakthrough depends upon you getting into position. You got the word. Now move. Glory be to God. Now move. Now move. Get into a position. Move. I know what it feels like to have to move and do things that are uncomfortable. I know what it's like to have to leave a religious system and just go. Sometimes God will tell you just go and figure it out and go, and he'll be with you. Sometimes you just have to move. Whatever it is. Business. God ordained. Marriage, business, work, family, disconnect from sinful friends, disconnect from this and disconnect from that. Because there's a whole lot of people who are believing a breakthrough for God. They believe God can do it, but they won't get into position of holiness. That is also a big one. Get into position of holiness with God. Because you got a whole lot of people who will get mad at God because something they prayed for has not happened. Now, there's some people, you're in position with God. There's some people, man, they love God. They're on fire for God. They do it the Lord's way. I'm not referring to you. Pray for those people who are out of position. Okay? But there are some people who are mad at God because what they believe him to do is not done yet. Now, some people, not all, some things are not a reality yet because of God's timing. Some things for some people are not a reality yet because they are not in position. Because some people are living in sin and they want God to bless them while they hold on to the things of this world and from the enemy. That is not going to work. You have to be in position with God to get what God has for you. There's a lot of people who want the blessing, but they don't want the sacrifice to live holy and righteous unto the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We serve a God that's holy and righteous. There's too many people that would try to make shortcuts. They want to make shortcuts. They want the blessings of God. There's people who factually believe that God is real. They know God is real. They know that God created. He's the creator of everything. But they will not surrender to holiness. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. They won't surrender to holiness. And then they'll get mad at God because what they are believing, they have not seen it yet. Well, God is saying that if you would get into position and if you would deny your flesh and if you would turn from sin, I will bless you. Hallelujah. Glory to God. God is saying, turn from sin, get into position, a position of obedience to be able to receive what thus saith the Lord. Glory to God. Noah got into position. Abraham got into position. Mary and Joseph got into position for the birthing of Jesus. Hallelujah. Joshua, they went around the walls of Jericho. They got into position. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Elijah got into position and went to the widow's house. Get into position. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Moses got into position and went to Pharaoh. And the Red Sea was eventually parted. Get into position and do what God is telling you to do. If he said make a YouTube channel and distribute the word of God, do it. Hallelujah. If he's saying that disconnect yourself from this religious system, do it. If he's saying disconnect yourself from this ungodly relationship, do it. If he's saying to disconnect yourself from this sin, do it. If he's saying to disconnect yourself from this, do it. If God is saying to get up and go after that job, do it. If God is saying start that business, he'll be with you. Do it. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. And I feel this. Quit worrying about what you don't have now. Because there are some people who say, well, I'm not going to move and get into position until I, you know, until this is right. And if that is right, I am a living witness. There are some things that God told me and my family to do, and everything was in disorder. Hallelujah. God told me to preach on this channel. And I said, God, how can I preach on this channel? And I'm homeless. God said, minister the word of the Lord. And in due time, I will deliver you. Hey, hallelujah. Glory to God. You got to move even when everything's around you is falling apart. Move. Who am I talking to? Move. Get into position. Whatever God is saying, quit worrying about, you know, what you have and don't have. God would tell you to go. Hallelujah. I was ministering in this car because me and my family were homeless. Hallelujah. While my family was back at the hotel. Hallelujah. I would go somewhere and park and still preach the word of God. Nobody never knew. But God said, keep going. Sometimes you have to get into position through adversity, circumstances, spiritual warfare. Get into position. If you're stressed out, get into position of God. Hallelujah. If your finances are limited, get into position. Glory be to God. If you're going through spiritual warfare, get into position. Hallelujah. Going through things in your family, going through things in your body and your children, get into position of God, because what you're doing is you're saying, God, even though I'm going through in my life, I still choose to get into position with you. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. I started this YouTube channel in a broken state of mind. Hallelujah. I said, God, though I'm hurting from the things in the past, I refuse to let that stop me from doing the work of the Lord. Some of you, stop trying to figure it out. Hallelujah. Stop trying to figure it out and move. Get into position. It is important that you move immediately. Hallelujah. You getting into position, not only is it going to bless you, but it's going to bless your family. It's going to bless your bloodline. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Who am I talking to in this season? Glory be to God. God is talking to you. Get into position. I felt that when I feel the anointing of God on this one. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Get into position. Get into position. Come on. Get into position. Come on now. You feel it. You see it. You sense it. Get into position. Avoid sin. Stay away from the things of the enemy. Cling to God. Get into position. Noah got into position. Look at all of these Bible references all around us that it gives examples of spiritual victory for those who got into position with the Lord. Glory be to God. That is the word of God on today. And I hope and pray that something was said or mentioned that will make an impact in your life. That will make an impact in your life. Glory be to God. And I pray, I speak that you would step out of your comfort zone, that you would get into position and do what God has called you to do as you await breakthrough. As you await breakthrough. Again, as always, thank you. And I, for all of you who have dropped by this channel and have supported this channel, I declare the blessings and the direction and the strength of God over your life, for you and your family. That every time I post a word, that you receive it, that you would digest it, that you would focus on it so that God's word can come to pass in your life. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. And remember, no weapon formed against you or your family shall prosper. God loves you. I love you with the love of the Lord. Until next time, be blessed and be safe. Amen.